Is that you, my fine feathered friend? Yes, Lord Baelish, it is I. Please forgive my peculiar appearance, but you of all people should appreciate that a convincing disguise is oft more tactical than a gold coin secreted into an ambitious palm. Aye, that I do, Lord Varys, that I do. I, however, will stick to wielding the gold, so do tell, and please satisfy my curiosity. What obliges our clandestine meeting here in this shuttered soup room, lost in a forgotten quarter of King's Landing? News to tell? To the contrary, actually. I've not news, but rather some knowledge to impart that I hope you'll find indispensable in your upcoming endeavor. My little birds, you see, have sung to me of the song of your impending departure to the Vale of Arryn. I'll speak not of my travels, but what indispensable, as you say, knowledge would this be, Lord Varys? Well, allow me to remove the delicacy of this conversation. It's been quite some time since you've visited the Vale, and while you're there, you'll most certainly need to fashion, however craftily, your team of players in this Game of Thrones, shall we say. Now, I have my little birds, and you'll need yours, if you are to prove efficacious.
I'm all ears and all eyes, my good friend.
Yes, very well then. Come closer and I'll show you the instrument that I, the spider, use to weave my webs within webs of both information and, human capital. You see here, I craft my schemes using Microsoft Project. Yet I use that tool in unification with Project Online. This allows me to untangle and make sense of all that I have entwined.
Fascinating. I do see the profit of it. Go on, please.
Let's focus on your pawns, your resources. You will, of course, have already crafted your complex ruse using Microsoft Project. This is essentially all of the activities that make up your scheme. Then, using Project Online, you will assemble a team of players or assets who are specific to performing the tasks in the scheme. This is powerful, you see, because it allows you to maintain a categorized list of your assets, both humans and non. Here's how it works. You highlight one of your schemes in the list on the Projects page. Click the Projects tab to expose the concealed ribbon of commands, and then select Build Team, like this. You can also choose Filter Group or select Other Views in order to narrow your focus to those resources that meet the particular needs of your ploy. Once you have some assets selected, simply click the Add button and they'll be added to your team, as shown to the right of the buttons.
Absolutely beguiling, but I must ask, what function does the Replace button perform?
Ah, you've a keen eye, Lord Baelish. This allows you to swap out a member currently on your team with a resource from the reserve pond on the left. Simply make your selections, one from each side, and click the Replace button. Dreadfully effortless. Agreed?
Yes, yes. I would, Lord Varys. I am truly in your debt. Truly. I am already imagining how to employ this powerful tool to my advantage. I am already thinking of all the alliances I can forge and replace with this button.
I suppose you are in my debt. But understand this, Lord Baelish. What I do for the good of the realm.
The realm? Do you know what the realm is? It's the thousand blades of Aegon's enemies. A story we agree to tell each other over and over, until we forget that it's a lie.
But what do we have left once we abandon the lie? Chaos. Microsoft Project can help keep us out of chaos. However, do understand that I've not revealed to you everything you require to master this tool. I'm afraid there's simply not enough time at present. But before you reach the Vale of Arryn, detour from the high road southeast to Redfort. There you'll find Lord Todmere, with House EPMA, whose sigil is Projects Refined, Work Simplified. Look to them for additional Microsoft Project and Project Online wisdom. But keep this close to your chest. Secrets are worth more than the silver of sapphires.